The death of the US dollar as the world's reserve currency will have negative effect on the lives of most Americans. Unfortunately, 99% of the population has no clue about what lies ahead. The dollar is on life support, if not already dead, drowned in fiat devaluation and debt. Pretty sure the dollar was destroyed a while back. Gluttony, greed, and sloth, but mostly arrogance. It is paper and electrons now. The Fed's money printing policy is destroying the dollar. All currencies will collapse. We are the reserve, so we are the big domino that will crush everything else. Fiat money always goes back to zero. Welcome to Atlantis Report. Here are four things that are going to destroy the dollar. Number 1. Endless wars funded by the Federal Reserve absorbing the resultant debt. Number 2. Presidents that encourage cheaper dollars in order to pump economic numbers for re-election purposes falsely. Number 3. A House of Representatives that ignores their fiscal duties and spends all their energies on attacking the other party. Number 4. A Federal Reserve that ignores its second and third mandates under which they are allowed to operate. A. Promoting an inflation rate that yields a 22% price increase in 10 years, stable prices. B. Ignoring their promote moderate, not extreme, long-term rates. Record lows are extreme by definition. It is estimated that 50% of the hard dollars in circulation are overseas. And remember, all the central bankers and politicians that root for inflation all have inflation-protected pensions awaiting them. The international monetary system has collapsed 3 times in the past 100 years, in 1914, 1939, and 1971. Each collapse was followed by a period of tumult, war, civil unrest, or significant damage to the stability of the global economy. The American dollar has been the global reserve currency since the end of the Second World War. If the dollar fails, the entire international monetary system will fail with it. No other currency has the deep, liquid pools of assets needed to do the job. Optimists have always said, in essence, that there's nothing to worry about, that confidence in the dollar will never truly be shaken, no matter how high our national debt or how dysfunctional our government. But in the last few years, the risks have become too big to ignore. While Washington is gridlocked and unable to make progress on our long-term problems, our biggest economic competitors, China, Russia, and the oil-producing nations of the Middle East, are doing everything possible to end U.S. monetary hegemony. The potential results: financial warfare, deflation, hyperinflation, market collapse, chaos. The fundamental problem is that money and wealth have become more and more detached. Money is transitory and ephemeral, and it may soon be worthless if central bankers and politicians continue on their current path. But true wealth is permanent and tangible, and it has real value worldwide. Everyday citizens who save and invest have become guinea pigs in the central banker's laboratory. The world's major financial players, national governments, big banks, multilateral institutions, will always muddle through by patching together new rules of the game. The real victims of the next crisis will be small investors who assumed that what worked for decades will keep working. Until 1971, the world was financially stable. Currencies were covered by gold, the real economy was in imbalance with the amount of money available. Then US President Nixon needed money for the Vietnam War. He switched on the money printing machine, not least because OPEC had increased oil prices. This money then flooded the world. Banks came up with new investment models. They now wanted to make money not with goods but with money alone. This was the start of the financial industry of today. Credit cards and current accounts accelerated financial transactions. Former public responsibilities were privatized, pensions are a case in point, the private sector is better at everything than the state, so they said. New billions came into play. In the 1980s, Margaret Thatcher deregulated the banks in London. Bill Clinton did the same later on Wall Street. Money was to earn money and thereby create growth. The global casino was open for business. This path of liberalization was a mistake, it's also the wrong word. If you deregulate markets that need to be regulated, then you create chaos, you unleash an avalanche of money onto the world. You can call that liberalization, but it was a policy that benefited only a few people, namely the rich. It has caused a lot of problems for the world. The liberalization of deregulation allowed the deals of the banks to explode. They now acted internationally. Major banks have become investment establishments that fund huge deals. more and more money goes into speculation. That's where big money is made. This has less and less to do with the real economy. The money creation process also seems to be something of a mystery among academics and even in the banking boardrooms. The banks are silent for a reason. They would have to explain to their customers that these days, it's them creating the money and them benefiting hugely as a result. Money isn't neutral, after all. It's not the central banks, but private banks that generate most of this new money. A process is also known as deposit money creation. The money is created when someone goes to a bank to take out a loan. The bank opens an account and issues the funds. It's then in a contract with the individual who's taken out the loan. The bank hopes that the person will pay it back someday. That means that the original impulse to create money comes from private banks. Private banks basically create new money as they wish. That used to be the privilege of the mint of governments. It's a privilege to create money and, therefore, profits out of nothing. This privilege has been in the hands of the financial industry for a long time, and in recent years it's been unchecked. The US dollar is already down, and the US presidential election 2020 and political and policy uncertainties are going to make it much, much worse. The end of the US dollar signifies the renaissance of the US economy. Most likely to the detriment of economies of the rest of the planet. But it will be after a very long pain for the population, and maybe even a civil war. That's why they arm police to the teeth, with military hardware. It won't be done in 5 years. Far too many people put far too much stock into a reserve currency status. That was only ever a point about political power, not economic power. Obama started weaponizing the US dollar reserve with Russian sanctions. Then, Trump, the moron, took that on steroids, and now has sanctions on 40% of the world population. Of course, the world will dump the dollar. All it takes is competition. The euro and yuan are already classified as reserve currencies. Euro is scared of money so they won't expand. The yuan doesn't have dollar distribution around the world. But with a digital yuan, that is no longer an issue. It will save money to defeat the dollar. Australia trades in yuan for iron ore and coal to China, saving 11% on every transaction over the US dollar. Be aware that the dangers of a weaponized reserve currency were discussed at Bretton Woods. But the US was pretty much the only nation unscathed by World War II. So we delivered hard terms to the British. Everyone else was blown to bits. So the US took full advantage. But the concerns are well known and didn't become an issue until the two back-to-back economic illiterates Obama and Trump got to the office. Most of the world thought Obama was just an apparition, and nobody would be stupid enough to continue those policies. But they were wrong. Trump loves Obama's bullying and headed straight to sanctions and tariffs. Goldman did a white paper on this and estimated the US could see its GDP shrink 30% if it loses its reserve currency dominance. I guess Larry Kudlow and the other Trump brain trust missed this one too. China will introduce its digital yuan, allowing any nation to deal directly with China, avoiding any US sanctions. Also remember that the Chinese banks are the largest in the world, 40% larger than all the US banks combined. So they can handle any level of transaction in any quantities. Trump sold everyone on the false notion that he was the big businessman. He had one job in his life, working for Shyster Fred, chasing down delinquent rentals. He stupidly destroyed 65 million metric tons of soy contracts with a single tweet because he knew nothing about futures contracts. In a tweet, he said the federal government would backstop soy futures contracts losses. That instantly triggered force majeure, and all the 65 million metric tons of contracts, the largest in the history of the country, became instantly voidable. That is remarkable stupidity, ignorance, and an act of a total imbecile that knows nothing. Trump is selling you on his tariffs and his sanctions. The rest of the world is dumping any and all dependence on US products. And the dollar is next on the dump list. Trump will go down in history as the idiot that bankrupted the country. The root cause of the problem is spending and living beyond its means. Trillions wasted on wars for the deep state agenda. How exactly did this benefit the people who paid for it? The dollar has been dead. In fact, it has lost 99% of its value. At this time, all I can see is the central banks dragging out the fiat systems for as long as they can. And they are quietly buying up gold on the cheap as much as they can and for as long as they can. The US dollar will be the last fiat standing. Once the dollar disintegrates, then the people will really get pissed off and may even realize that fiat, and then, guilt by association, also realize that Bitcoin is also a BS currency because it is unbacked. Then people will scramble for gold, but guess what, like Rob Kirby says, no physical will be available for purchase by then, or it will be outrageously expensive. It will take time, but the people will really have no choice. Since the dollar in theory, at some point, will be worthless. And gold or silver unobtainable. The government will then have the people trapped and be able to force them into the central bank and government digital Fed coin, which naturally will be unbacked. It's all about control. The end result is America's trade policies have been instrumental in hastening the end of the dollar as the world's reserve currency, ultimately leading to its destruction. That is all by design. Make sure you have supplies, gold, silver, guns, and ammo, going to be a rocky ride. And get ready for a world currency. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.